Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to another awesome tutorial in Revit Low Modeling. Today I'm going to show you two and trick to create rebar size and rebar color in Revit. I think it would be pretty interesting because I make a lot of my previous tutorial about reinforcement rebar and why I need to create a new rebar size. I think this question and some you before beginner level are struggling for create a new rebar size for some parts, and why I need to create that, because I think in every country around the world we got a different code for design and for structural analysis, and for the rebar is also different depend on country. And some country they are using for Russian code or Japanese code or American code, but by the way in my country we are using for ACI code. Let me explain to you a bit about why I need to change rebar size, and you can skip here a couple minutes for jumping to our tutorial. And let me go to my Google here first. Here is our ACI code. As you can see, here is the ACI code book. It's the American code here, but using in my country. I think I explained you a bit more. What is ACI code? ACI code is the American Concrete Institute publication. More than 400 standards that apply to the manufacture, use and maintenance of concrete in a variety of applications. Their standard also determines methods for testing, inspection, and building code requirement. This is the ACI code, and you can find more on the internet what exactly is ACI code, because it's a big code that for structural engineer they are using for analyze like wind load or concrete design for structural engineer. And some country they are using for robot analysis or ETAP. It depends what they're using. Okay, let's jumping around together for my tutorial. Okay, before I get started, if you are first time to visiting to my channel or reaching out to my channel and you didn't know about me yet, my name is Ben from Revit Global Knowledge, and I create this channel for help you to start from zero to hero and from beginner level to professional level. And my work is let's grow for future construction together. And anyway, don't forget to hit subscribe button below and turn on notification for more about Revit, because you come to the right place if you want to learn Revit. And your like and your subscriber is motivate me to do more content about Revit. Okay, so let's jumping around together for our tutorial. And here is my previous tutorial that I have created one before I start to in my video. And this is a rebar size for rebar color with my rebar size that I have created one for representation. So I just want to create a new one first. Control and on my keyboard for template, and here in this case I prefer for structural template because we are using for structure. It's okay. In some parts when you are using for architectural template, you might be need to go to your load family for rebar step here inside your project template, because at default architecture template didn't help for rebar step, but mine are using for structural template, but I have no issue about that. So I'm going to structure here, then go to rebar here. So now I want to create my rebar. By creating that, I need to go to my edit type here, and of course there I can duplicate and train a rebar size. I think I just train a little bit only for my country because it's RB8, and I just hit OK. And this one I change it to plan, and this one change it to 8. I think it will be error a little bit. If you want to exact size, you can go to Google and type out. And this one I think is okay one for me. Then I'm going to duplicate again, adding another DB16, and just hit OK. And this one I'm going to change it for 16 for material default here. Just keep it like this. Change this one to default. Just hit OK. Okay, As you can see now, I finished creating my rebar already. So how can I show you? Let's say we want to add a new column here using a freeform. If you didn't know yet about the freeform rebar, you can check that link in description for freeform rebar. I in my previous tutorial. So and otherwise, you can check a look for in description. I got doing for reinforcement rebars for footing, column and beam. Okay, this one I'm going to my 3D here, and my previous one I want to delete first. I don't want to sell. Okay, as you can see, here is my normal column here. So I want to place my rebar that I have created before. So I just select my rebar, my column here like this, go to rebar and using for preform rebar here, use align, start from the bottom one, another one here and the egg here, and using for stereo for RBA, and for layout I change is for maximum spacing. Then I need to use a pad here for pad to something like this. Then hit finish, hit escape a couple of times. As you can see now, I have placing my rebar already. That using freeform rebar is quite fast. And don't mind me because this one I just give a quick example. I never calculate one. So you just let your rebar here for turn on your solid rebar. Easier for you guys take a look. Change this one to fine again. Okay. As you can see now, we got our stereo rebar around here. So we need to add another vertical one because we got create two. You can create many steps that you want, depend on how many rebar side that you use into your project. I'm going to my level 2 here like this one, change this one to fine. By right, we need to take it on the web one, but I think it's okay one because it's just a quick tutorial. Select my concrete column here, go to rebar and using for near cover reference for parallel here, change to parallel to cover here, and I start plus something, change this one to 16 millimeter like this one, and I start the center here something like this, and another guy like this one, hit this one, and the arm on my keyboard for draw mirror, I start draw mirror something like this, and this one also. I select my rebar RD, right click on my cursor, go to select all instant project in instant project, and go to visibly set here, set to 3D and solid, hit OK. Okay guys, as you can see now, we finished our rebar already, and this one is exact size that I want, that we are using SEI code in my country, and my country we got only for we start from 8 millimeter rebar size. Okay, now we finish our part 1 already. Let's continue to our part 2 with a 3 main way to create rebar color for representation. Okay, so now I am continue for my previous one for create rebar color for presentation. So graphic presentation, by creating we got 3 main way to create that one. You just go to your select your rebar here something like this, then go to edit type here, and then you can drop down finding for material here, but I not highly recommend to use this method because will be take your file too heavy and some more will be affect your 3D, because I think as a default 3D default is better than rebar color, but I just give you a quick tutorial so you can know what is the first way to create your rebar color like this one, as you can see. And this one going to change reflective something like this because we don't want my completely reflective. Apply, hit OK. Change this one to realistic. As you can see, now we finish our first step already, but we will be affected with our rebar color because we are changing for material. By the way, we can create another second way, but the most highly recommend one, I highly recommend for the third way because let's wait until finish, you will know that. I'm going to undo a few seconds. Okay, everything is as a normal. So I just like my rebar here, something like this. Right click on my cursor, go to override graphic in view, go to by element. And for background here, change pattern here, change this one to which color where you want. I just want to, let's say orange. Apply, hit okay. As you can see now, my rebar is changed as the same before, and when I turn on for realistic, it's come as a normal. But I don't highly recommend that when you using for rebar for presentation, because why? When you have many set, will be take more time to do that. Let's say it, I want to change here and go to override graphic here by element, and this one change this one to something like this, green color. And this one, make sure change this one to solid. Apply, hit okay. As you can see now, we got train only one, and another guy here is still as a normal. That will be take your time when you have many or three bar that you want to change color. So I'm highly recommend for the start way. The last one, I'm going to undo a few seconds. Okay, let's go to the final one, which is on my keyboard for visibly graphic or VV. Or you can sometimes you can go to visibly graphic here on the view tab here, or you just like already bar here, then right click on your cursor, go to override graphic in view again, but we go to the last one by filter, just like here. Then here is a filter, then you need to add one because here is nothing. Go to edit and new here, create new here, and give a name for RBX. Make sure your rename filter here and this one is correct, same as your rebar you create one, because the read will link together. It's your rebar name is different, will be messy. So I just hit OK first, and as you can see, I got check my structural rebar already. Then you need to check here. Then I just drop down here, change it for tie name because we want to link. Make sure your tie name here is correctly also RBA as a rebar name that I created before. I drop down finding for constant, it's apply. As you can see, go to new here, create a new one for RB. Okay, this last one DB16. It's okay. Then here is structural rebar how take already. Then you can also can drop down to finding some swing structural rebar like this one, like mine, and just drop down finding for tie name, and it's one add for DB16. All of these three guy, 1, 2, 3 guy are the same. Make sure go to constant, apply. Then okay, let me take a look. Everything is fine. Hit okay. Now we still nothing because we never add that. So you can go to add here, then select these two guys. Control key on my keyboard for multiple selection. And now I want to change override for my A bar here and change to solid. Change this one to yellow color. Yep. Okay. Hit apply. And go to the last one and go to pattern best here. Change this one to red color. Okay. Okay, again apply. Okay, and there we go. So now as you can see, one we change our rebar here, our remaining for the same size as our rebar is will be changed automatically. And this one is how you can create your 3D representation your to your client, it and you can identify with what kind of and the diameter of rebar that you use this you into a client project for structural engineer. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial, and thanks you guys for watching from start to finish. Again, don't forget to hit subscribe button below and turn off for notification to learn more about Revit, because I make content about Revit for every week, and sometimes I will bring 2 or 3 or 4 depend on I got a lot on project on hand or not. I got more free time, I will do that. By the way, your like and your subscriber is really motivate me to do more content. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and I think we will take too long already. Take a look on the end card, and if you want to watch another awesome tutorial, Thanks you guys and have a nice day. See you again for another tutorial. Bye bye.